last time. We'll see the Atlanta Braves as they play against the Baltimore Orioles. And with the first pitch coming right up, let's go out to Baltimore and join our broadcast team of Gary Thorne, John Kruk, and Steve Phillips.
Welcome, everybody. 2K Sports presents Major League Baseball Thursday afternoon with Gary Thorne, Steve Phillips, and John Kruk. Adam Jones, he can fly and he can hit the long ball. He'll be one of our treats to watch in this game. And out there, this vast crowd, almost 49,000. And our starting pitcher for Baltimore. And Steve, as he faces these Atlanta hitters, what's he looking at?
Scouting report against this lineup is if you execute your pitches, hit your spots, keep the ball down in the zone, you can shut them down. And with a quality left-hander like this on the mound, he shouldn't have too much difficulty.
Lineup time. Here's a look at how Freddy Gonzalez has lined them up today. Scouting pick, John, who are we looking at today?
Well, the power numbers haven't come for Nick Markakis yet, but he's still a big threat with the bat in his hand. Nothing he does to overexert himself. He stays on an even keel, very consistent.
And here's Nick Markakis leading it off.
For the Atlanta Braves, right fielder, number 21, Nick Markakis.
Here's the pitch. Smash towards the middle, and the leadoff man's on board. You love the offense when it gets going that way. Now we'll show you how the Orioles are lined up around the field. John, who's a factor for them?
Adam Jones, a converted infielder, hasn't lost a step. He made that transition to the outfield. Still learning the nuances of playing outfield on an everyday basis in the big league, but he's a gifted, gifted athlete. Big, strong, athletic, very quick. Great throwing arm. Adam Jones has a chance to be one of the top outfielders for a long, long time.
And our game's first out is in the books. That's going to bring up Freddie Freeman. Well, if you're going to sacrifice, that's the pitch you want. Right down the middle of the plate, you got it.
And you need players to execute that. It's not easy when it's coming in there at 95 miles per hour.
And Freeman will come to the plate.
Well, you know, the Braves want to forget what happened at the end of the year last year, but they had an
hit in the dirt. And Hardy picks it up. That's the second out. In regards to that Atlanta collapse, and they're going to have to hear this throughout baseball history, the Braves were 10.5 up on the Cardinals August 26th, and it all disappeared, Steve.
You know, that September record, they went 10-20, including 5 losses to end the regular season. If they had just won one of those games, they would have gone to the playoffs.
All the way to the wall. And Markakis scores.
Now batting.
Now the pitcher left this one over the middle part of the plate, right where the hitter can make contact. Good piece of hitting.
Boy, with a run scoring there, that's a pretty fat pitch in an RBI situation.
Keep the rally going.
It's going to be Johnson now. You know, they've done themselves quite a job here. This is a nice push at this point of the ball game to get out in front. Ball is blasted, a long high drive deep to center field. Goodbye, home run, a two-run digger. A little distance now, increasing their lead, 1-3.
They need to be careful right here, Gary. Braves just continue to score. What a great job.
A.J. Krasinski.
Swing and a ball pop foul down the right field line.
Foul!
Strike and two. That's a strike. A.J. Krasinski now behind in the count. Defensive stance at the plate. And we've got offense here in the first inning, just the way they wanted to start this ball game.
Now the pitching's going to have to settle down here. Now I know it's early, but you don't want this thing to spiral out of control.
So he ended that half inning with a strikeout. Great execution, knocking in some runs right from the get-go. The Braves are out in front, 3-0. Here's a look at Atlanta's starter. As he gets into this Baltimore lineup, Steve, strategy-wise?
Well, Chin-Ming Wong has that exceptional sinker ball. He gets a lot of ground ball outs, low three-quarter arm delivery. The question is, will his slider be effective or not? He has to keep his hand on top of it.
Here's the delivery.
Strike
Strike two with that one. Now it's 0-2. Alejandro Deheza will have to protect.
I threw that one exactly where he wanted it, down and in.
That swung on, hit on the ground. Simmons. Out. That's one away. This is the lineup we'll see for the Orioles. So who are you looking at, John?
Well, so many gifted athletes in Major League Baseball right now, but Adam Jones has to be near the top of that list. He can do it all for a kid who's still learning the game. Once he learns it and once he gets comfortable and believes in his talent, the sky's the limit for how great he can become.
And here's a look at Atlanta on defense. This is what we're going to be seeing on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, second fewest number of errors committed in the National League. That's what you're looking at right here with this team defense. And, you know, they make plays, great range, great hands, and they execute, making the fundamental outs.
Grounded up the middle, Simmons. And a good throw gets him, two down. And here's Adam Jones. He's gone 5-for-22 lifetime against the Braves.
And just hasn't ever been able to get dialed in against this team throughout his career.
This one's grounded foul, wide of first. Jinming Wong, he runs the count to 0-2.
Well, with a couple strikes on him, Gary, I'm going to go right at him with a slider now. He struggles with that pitch.
And Jones swings, hits this one. And there's Upton, pulls that one in for the third out. So Jinming Wong gets him three up and three down. He gets through the first inning without allowing a hit. And next, it'll be the Braves getting it going. Beating down a bit this afternoon, a real heat factor. Kiaspo at the plate. He'll start us out here in the second. This one swung on and driven hard. This one to Jones. As he just strolls over for that out.
Designated hitter, number 35.
Number 8 spot in the lineup. And of course, as a pitcher, you got to keep your eye on which pitches are effective on any given day and which ones aren't. Here's a look at which pitches he's thrown that have generated hits.
This guy.
There's a swing and a drive, deep right field. No problem for him. That's an easy out.
First ball hit toward the wall. You see the right fielder backpedaling. You don't recommend that because your head bounces around and you can fall, but still able to make the catch.
And B.J. Upton will stand in, two down. Here's the pitch. Now a swing pops him up left side of the infield. This one towards Hardy. And there's the third out. Well, that's one way to keep your pitch count down. They wrap that inning up with three pitches. Braves 3, Baltimore nothing. And if you're just joining in, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Cronk bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. And Chris Davis to bat. He's in his fifth MLB year. A swing and a ball hit high into the air, right field. This one was crunched. Goodbye, home run, Orioles. They're on the board. They wish that homer had been chased in a couple more. They'll take it, though, only down two.
Well, good-looking power swing right there. Has just enough on it to drive it over the wall in right field.
And these are ones what the hitter and outfielder want to take a second look. How far did I get it out? And the outfielder, how far did I just miss it by?
When they take the third look, he'll be crossing home plate, slapping high fives. Good surge by the Orioles right here, getting themselves back into this game. Now it's neck and neck as they've cut the deficit.
Strike. Wong's got him 0-1.
Well, they're not all the way back yet, but they're closing in.
And at this point, they really didn't need to get all the way back. They just needed a feel that the offense was going to be there for them.
And boy, nothing spells momentum like home run.
Strike two!
Wieters watches it. It's a strike. At the belt, Wong kicks, throws. Fastball swung out and missed, struck him out, one away.
The ability to move your pitches around within the zone, to change a hitter's eye level and keep them off balance are critical to success. Very successful there, three pitches and a strikeout.
And we're going to see Pierce here.
Well, one thing we can say about the Orioles, they are consistent with their play at home. Unfortunately, they're consistently just under the 500 mark in Baltimore.
First pitch is a changeup, looked at 0-1. Last season for the O's, that record was 39-42 at home. 37 wins in 2010, 39-09, 37-08, Steve, on and on.
Yeah, you go back to 2003, it's the last time they were even at 500, a 40-40 record that year. And listen, this is about personnel. They need to get some better pitching to shut down these big offenses in the American League East.
Swings and grounds this one foul, wide a third. Slider in there and gets him looking, two down.
Get a chance to take a look at this slider right here, Gary.
J.J. Hardy.
Well, two strikes, that's exactly where the pitcher wants to put the ball. But as a hitter, you have to try to fight it off and make contact.
And it's J.J. Hardy at the plate. Hitting just .217 lifetime off the Braves. Called strike. Long's got him 0-1. Swing and a rocket toward short. And the sides retired as they head into the dugout. Narrow their deficit a bit. They pick up a run on the dinger. Baltimore trying to get back into a position to challenge in this game.